वॉइस इज नॉट कमिंग।
Did you read today's thought? Behind the parents stands the school, then behind the teacher, the home. Do you know who has written this quote?
No.
You might be knowing former President Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. He has written this quote explaining the importance of school and teachers. The teachers sometimes have to play the role of parents and as we call the school second home, as it is said, because you gain knowledge, you know, discipline, and you achieve success in life. So school is called the second home.
सर आपके पास PDF का तो स्टॉक है सर।
PDF आई हैव टू कीप।
स्टॉक स्टॉक है स्टॉक।
यस। थाउजेंड्स ऑफ PDF आई हैव। यस्टरडे वी वर रीडिंग दिस। So I'll explain the part which we have read. Next day was Jimmy Valentine's day of release from the prison. So Jimmy Valentine was about to come out of the prison. It was the day of his release. He was going to come out. Now, Valentine, you will go out in the morning, brace up, and make a man of yourself. You are not a bad fellow at heart. Stop breaking safes and leave straight. So this is Warden, the man who takes care of the prisoners over there. He advised Jimmy not to break safes, means not to do all that wrong things which he was doing, that burglaries that he had done. He should stop doing it and he should leave straight. He told him to brace up. It is given in the meanings. To be courageous or strong. Make a man of yourself means now be honest. Don't cheat anyone. Then Jimmy was surprised. He said, I never cracked a safe in my life. So see, he's acting so innocent, like sometimes you all act innocent, that I have not done anything wrong ever. Same way, Jimmy is acting really innocent. If he had not done anything wrong, why was he in the prison till now? So Jimmy is talking with the warden that I never cracked a safe in my life. I never did anything wrong. Oh no, of course not. Let's see. How was it you happened to be sent up on that Springfield job? So now warden is asking Jimmy that if you have not done anything wrong, then why were you sent to jail till now? Why were you in the prison? Me? Why, warden? I was never in Springfield in my life. So Jimmy said that I was never involved in any of the burglaries in my life. I have never done anything wrong. He is not ready to accept. But till now he was in the prison. So without any reason he was not in the prison. Of course, he had committed so many robberies. He had done so many wrong things. He cheated people, and so he was in the prison, not without any reason. So now he is going to come out of the prison the next day, and he is having a conversation with this warden. Till here, you understood?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Take him back, Cronin, said warden to the guard. Now there was a guard standing near the warden. So warden said to guard that take him back and fix him up with outgoing clothes. Means give him his clothes which he had worn when he was arrested. Give his clothes back, because the next day, 7 in the morning, he was going to be released. Better think over my advice, Valentine. Valentine means Jimmy Valentine. Warden is still giving advice to Jimmy that what advice I have given you, live straight, live an honest life, think about it. And 7 in the morning, he was going to get released. Now at 7:15, what is the meaning of 7:15?
It's 45.
What is the time? Tell me.
It's
7:15. Correct. 6:45. Is it 7:15 or 7:45? This is 7:15. 7:15. Next morning, Jimmy stood in warden's outer office. So Jimmy was going home now. The clerk handed him a train ticket and a $5 bill, with which law expected him to rehabilitate himself into a good citizenship and prosperity. So when Jimmy was released, when he was free, what was given to him? One train ticket was given and $5 bill. You can say $5. $5, the currency. Two things were given to him: train ticket and $5 bill. So government was expecting that he would rehabilitate, means to help a person to be a part of the society again. The criminals who are in jail for a long time, then they are released. So the law expects them to rehabilitate, means again to be the part of the society and be a good citizen. So law was expecting that he would live with prosperity, happiness, and he would be a good citizen now. Mr. James Valentine walked out into the sunshine. Means finally he was free and he was walking out. Any doubt?
No, sir.
you understand?
Yes.
He proceeded leisurely and boarded his train. Leisurely means relaxed. Now he was very much relaxed. He means, who is he? Whom does he refer to?
Jimmy Valentine. Jimmy Valentine.
Okay. So now Jimmy was free of prison. So he boarded his train. In a relaxed way, he was going home. He went down into a little town, means where he lived. And first of all, he went to the cafe of one Mike Dolan and shook hands with Mike. Maybe he was his old friend. So he went to the cafe where Mike Dolan lived and shook the hands with Mike. And not only his friend, because Jimmy lived there, not in the cafe, but you see where. Got my key? Said Jimmy. So maybe he had given the keys to Mike Dolan when he was arrested. So he asked for the keys. He got his keys and went upstairs, unlocking the door of a room at the rear. So finally he got the keys, he went upstairs. Maybe there were the stairs just next to the cafe or just above the cafe where he lived. He had a room over there. So he unlocked the room and he entered the room. Everything was just as he had left it. There on the floor was still Ben Price's collar button that had been torn from eminent detective's shirt band when they had overpowered Jimmy to arrest him. So what do we understand by this? When Jimmy entered the room after so many months, we don't know for how long he was in the prison. Maybe for 6 months, 8 months or more than that. But when he came back to his house, everything was as it is. What was there on the floor? When Ben Price had come to arrest him, maybe they have quarreled. They had quarreled because they had to arrest Jimmy. And Jimmy was trying to run away. So they fought and they wanted to overpower Jimmy. So Ben Price pounced on him, attacked. And during this fight, the button, collar button of Ben Price had fallen down. And it was still there. So many months back, this happened. And it was still there in the same place. Understood?
Yes, sir.
What is the meaning of eminent? Eminent detective means what?
Respected.
Okay. The word eminent means loved and respected. This we had read. Had we read this?
No.
Yes, sir.
This paragraph. Now I want someone to read. Ms. Bach.
Yes, sir.
read the paragraph.
Pulling out from the wall, a folding bed, Jimmy slid back a panel in the wall and dragged out a dust-covered suitcase. He opened these and gazed fondly at the finest set of burglar's tools in the East. It was the complete set made of specially tempered steel, the latest designed in drills, punches, braces, and bits, Jimmy's clamps and augers.
Augers
with two or three novelties invented by Jimmy himself, in which he took pride.
So, as he reached his place, what did he take out? Pulling out from the wall a folding bed, Jimmy slid back a panel. Panel, brother? The flat rectangular surface. Sometimes those who have folding bed, usme se panel nikal sakte hain. We can keep the things inside. Anyone who has got that kind of bed, folding, we can open the panel, we can keep the things like pillow, blanket, and we can again close it. That is panel. Have you got it? Anyone?
Yes.
That kind of bed.
Yes.
So he opened that panel, and what did he take out? Dust-covered suitcase. Why was it dust-covered? Because it has been long time. He was not in his place. Now he has come back, but it is very dusty. And when he opened the suitcase, what was there inside it? All the tools. Burglar's tools, मतलब जो चोर के जो टूल्स होते हैं, which I already shown yesterday, all these things. In his suitcase, all these things were there, which he used for robbery. So he was gazing, he was looking at all these things that he had used all this for burglary. What was there? Specially tempered steel. Tempered means, you know, we have to heat the steel and then make it cold and we give it shape. And then the shape is given. That is tempered steel. First it is heated, then it is made cold. And then the shape is given. That is called tempered steel. My voice is breaking up, right?
No.
The latest designs. Now all the things, all the tools, names, drills, punches, braces and bits, Jimmy's, clamps, augers, all these tools were there. But what is the meaning of this? Two or three novelties. Novelties means new things which no one had, which Jimmy had invented. He was an expert burglar, expert chor tha wo. So he had invented some tools by himself, which no one had in the market. So he was very proud of himself that he's an expert in his field. And all these things, braces and bits, jimmies, clamps, drills, I already shown you. We will also write the names below the images of the tools given. Clear till here?
Yes, sir.
Yes, then read next. We'll read. Aisha.
Yes, sir. So, कहाँ से रीड करना है? मैं अभी आ रही हूँ.
See, I have marked it.
In half an hour.
Yes.
In half an hour, Jimmy went downstairs and through the cafe. He was now dressed in tasteful and well-fitting clothes, and carried his dusted and clean suitcase in his hand. A week after his release, there was a net job of safe burglary done in a nearby town. There was no clue left. Then a similar robbery was reported elsewhere, followed by another after 2 weeks. The losses were now high enough to bring the matter up into Ben Price's class of work. By comparing notes, a remarkable similarity in the methods of the burglaries was noticed. Ben Price investigated the scene of the robberies and was heard to remark, "Jim Valentine has resumed business.
Okay. So after half an hour, he went downstairs. First of all, he came home. He took out that suitcase in which all the tools were there. Now, after half an hour, he went downstairs. He was now dressed in tasteful and well-fitting clothes. How can clothes be tasteful? Were the clothes tasty? Actually, it means handsome, good-looking, and well-fitting clothes he had worn. And he carried dusted and cleaned suitcase in his hand. Now, that suitcase was clean. He dusted it, he cleaned it, and now he took it with him. So again, he was going for a robbery, right? Where was he going with the suitcase? Why did he carry suitcase with him?
Maybe he was leaving town.
Okay. See, then what happened? Just after 1 week, he was released, and just within that 1 week, what happened? There was a neat job of safe burglary done in the nearby town. Means where Jimmy lived. Just next to that town, there was a robbery, safe burglary, means no clue was left. And the burglary was done. Then similar robbery was reported elsewhere, followed by another after 2 weeks. So after Jimmy was released, two or three robberies were done in the nearby town. So obviously, the police will again doubt on him. The losses were now high enough to bring up the matter into Ben Price's class of work. Now, what is the meaning of this line? Anyone who can tell me? The losses were high enough, means the robberies which were done in that 1 week after when Jimmy was released. So many robberies were done. People had lost a lot of money. People had lost a lot of money, and so the case was handed over to Ben Price, because Ben Price was a detective. He was only given the case when it was a high profile case. And again, the case had become high profile because so many robberies were done, and there was a big loss incurred by the people in the nearby town. So Ben Price had to come in the scene because it was his job now. You know, when the crime is bigger, it is given to CBI. The case is given to CBI instead of the police department. You might know that.
Yes, sir.
Same way, here the case was handed over to Ben Price because it was his class of work, because the losses were very high. And when Ben Price started investigating, he saw that at the crime scene where the robbery was done, there was a lot of similarity, means the robbery was done in the same style. So Ben Price understood that
your voice is not coming.
Finally, it was done in the same style. Yes, I know it was breaking up.
Sir.
Okay. Sir, your voice is breaking.
Yes, I know my voice is breaking up. Sorry for that. Is it clear now? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So when Ben Price started investigating the crime scene where the robbery was done, he noticed that the robberies have been done in the same style. Means the robber is only one person. And this style, Ben Price already knew, is the kind of Jimmy Valentine's style. So Ben Price understood that this is no one but Jimmy Valentine who has resumed his business, means who has started his business of robbery again. And now he will search for Jimmy Valentine. Do you understand, Ilya?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now we will read.
Sir, can I?
Yes, mother, sir.
One afternoon, Jimmy Valentine climbed out of the train in the little town called Elmore. He looked like an athletic young senior just home from college. A young lady crossed the street past him at the corner and entered a door over which was the sign, the Elmer Bank. Jimmy Valentine looked into her eyes and forgot what he was and became another man. She lowered her eyes and colored slightly, young man of Jimmy's style and looks was carrier in Elmore.
Scarce.
Jimmy colored a boy. Yes, in Elmore. Jimmy collared a boy on the steps of the bank and asked him, isn't that young lady Polly Simpson?
Now, I already told you while I was telling you about the story. Now, Jimmy Valentine changed his address. He climbed out of the train in a little town called Elmore. So now, where did he go? He went to a new town. It was Elmore. See, it is capital. It is the name of the place. He had to change the place because who was looking for him? Who was on a hunt for Jimmy? Who was searching him?
Ben Price.
So what is taking so long? I thought you did not understand.
Remembering the name.
Okay. He looked like an athletic young senior.
Hard to remember.
Just home from college. So this is how he looked. He looked really young, like an athlete. The sports person, how energetic, strong, like a college going student. He looked just like that. Means he looked really good. A young lady crossed the street. Now, Jimmy, as soon as he entered Elmore, he saw a young lady who passed him at the corner, entered the door over which it was assigned, the Elmore Bank. So just when Jimmy was walking in the Elmore town, he saw one lady who was entering the gate. And above that gate, above that door where the lady entered, what was written? The banner was the Elmore Bank. Means that lady, that beautiful lady, entered the Elmore Bank. Jimmy saw her. And Jimmy looked into her eyes and he forgot what he was and he became another man. Means he thought just at that moment that I should stop my business of robbery. I should be a good man. I should live an honest life. Just within that one moment, he changed. Understood, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Yes, sir. So that was a kind of miracle. She lowered her eyes and colored slightly. Means that lady, she looked at Jimmy and colored slightly. Means she did not color her eyes. Means she acted like she was shy and she turned her face. First she looked at him, then her eyes became red and she was feeling shy. Young men of Jimmy's style and looks were scarce in Elmore. Scarce means very less, hardly you can see. Means Jimmy was one of the most handsome people in Elmore. There were very few people like him who looked as good looking as him. So he was one of the most good looking men in Elmore. He had got style, looks. Jimmy collared a boy on the steps of the bank and asked him. So collared means catch. Jimmy called one boy who was standing there and he asked that boy, isn't that lady Polly Simpson? So Jimmy thought that maybe I know that lady. Is she Polly Simpson? Jimmy asked that boy. Did you understand, Ilya? But actually,
yes,
she was not Polly Simpson.
Yes.
Who was she?
Annabelle.
Yes. See, this is the scene. Then boy, the boy said, no, she is Annabelle Adams. Her father owns this bank. So that boy gave the information about the girl, that this girl is not Polly Simpson. Her name is Annabelle Adams and she is the daughter of Mr. Adams, who is the owner of the Elmore Bank. You know, sometimes this is the trick to take the truth out of the person's mind. Sometimes I tell you that, is your name this? Intentionally, I speak any name and then you say, no, my name is not this. My name is this. But actually, I really don't know the name. That is just a trick to find out the name. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So here they meet,
yes,
for the first time. Then let's see what happens. From here we'll continue. Jimmy got information about the girl, that she is Rebel Adams and her father is the owner of the bank, the Elmore Bank. Now let's see what he does. See, he has got that suit coat in which all the tools are there. Yes?
Yes, it is.
Yes. Why?
He is not handsome.
Now what should I say? I don't know. But this is a cartoon image. You cannot judge the book by its cover.
Yes.
So you search, maybe you will get real Jimmy's photo on the internet. Okay?
Sir, Jimmy is Jimmy not there.
What?
Jimmy is not there. Jimmy is not
there. I can't hear you.
Jimmy is not there. Jimmy is not there.
Okay, you cannot get him on internet. Yeah. Okay. But these are those fictional characters. How will you find them? So we'll continue from there. Bye and have a nice day.
Bye, sir.
Bye, sir.
Nice day.
Bye, sir.